Oh, sweet mother of
bacon!
Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. It's Reverse BLT here, along with my mom, the mother of bacon, and we are continuing our binge watch of season 2 of The Expanse. This episode is episode 9, The Weeping Somnambulist, which means crying person who is sleeping, I think, or crying asleep person.
Try again?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's what somnambulist is, because I think somnambulate means to... Oh wait, no, sleepwalking. That's right, som is sleep, ambulate, yeah, movement. So... The crying sleepwalker, basically, is what that means.
It's probably that little kid.
Oh, yeah, May. Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, we're definitely going to see some more of May. So, yeah, I don't really think we need to really get too much into a recap here. You know, obviously, the stuff that happened, we already remember, you know, Prax met up with the crew. He's going to go help them. Well, he's going to go with them as they go back to Ganymede.
Yes.
Holden may have burned some bridges with Fred Johnson, though, of course, after helping him and Drummer survive a coup attempt, so maybe not super burnt, but by telling him that he has no intention of preserving any of the protomolecule on Ganymede so that Fred can, strengthen the belt's position, I guess, theoretically. And Naomi is continuing to hide the fact that she did not destroy their sample of the proto molecule and being awfully self-righteous about Holden keeping secrets from her while she's keeping probably the biggest secret of all.
Yes.
So yeah, that's pretty much it. So without any more preamble, let's just get into this.
So we need to stop.
Then why are they jamming our
girl? Uh-oh. Sound like you guys may have been bored. Like I said.
Look.
What do you think? They smuggling people?
Oh, they're on their way to Ganymede, so if they're smuggling people, they're smuggling to Ganymede.
That's outrageous!
Melissa, are you alright?
Wait, I know you. I've seen your face all over Sirius Station. You're James Holden.
Hey, James. Everyone know you.
Well, this is off to a good start.
What are you doing? I'm just helping this bright young lady adjust the sensor array.
That's hard to believe. I didn't think you had any useful skills. I want a full status report when you're done.
Of course, Colonel Genus.
Yeah, he's mispronouncing that. He's Portuguese, the Jay Silent.
That's Colonel Ames?
You may not have realized this, but Martha and I have buttocks where our heads should be.
Oh, Janus.
He's such an asshole.
Say Janus.
I'm rather excited about all this. When I was little, I was fascinated by stars. I thought they were magic. I kept coming up with all these crazy theories about how they worked. Drove my father crazy with all my questions.
Oh, I'm sure there are many other reasons.
I wanted to believe in magic.
Well, you know, that's normal for a child, right?
That's because children are stupid.
Uh-uh.
Just because you can't figure something out doesn't make it magic. What do you think Eros left behind on Venus? Little gray humanoids with big black eyes who come to turn us into food?
Ancient astronaut theorists say yes.
I'm astonished that Osrella didn't kick you out of her office.
Well, you know, just between the two of us, she's kind of got a thing for me, right?
Earth and Mars are mobilizing for war as we speak. They have better weapons than we do, and Eros was one of them.
Colonel, we just picked up an MCR and ship in Venus orbit. I don't know why we didn't see this before.
Must be a stealth. From the drive signature, probably a destroyer. They were waiting for us.
They need some people. Some ass. No, I don't think they have enough, though. I mean, people on that ship.
It's only like maybe 50 people on the Arbogast.
No, that's not enough mass. They need some more ships.
All right, need hand terminals, please.
Why are you doing this?
Because we need a ship to get us on the Ganymede station. Ours is too conspicuous.
The people there are suffering, you know. These supplies can save lives.
And they'll get what they needed. I promise.
I don't believe you.
Good.
Well, voila.
What we're doing is for the good of the belt and everyone else, whether you believe it or not.
Well, this ship is a grade A piece of shit.
Uh-uh.
It should get us to Ganymede.
Hello. My name is Praxidiki Meng.
You killed my father. Prepare to die.
You don't know me, but I was a colleague. I was a friend of your cousin Doris. We worked together on Ganymede. She saved my life. She got me out of the station when the mirrors fell. She was on her way back to Mars to be with you, but she was badly injured in transit.
She was let out of an airlock.
She probably wouldn't have even been on the ship with me if she hadn't helped me. So I want to say I'm sorry. She was a good person. I promise I'll never forget her and what she did for me. Never.
You're a prisoner.
Amos. Amos! Answer me when I called.
I was busy. Come on, we need you upstairs.
No, I need to send a message.
You can't.
It's important.
That doesn't make a difference.
Why can't I?
Cap said.
Am I a prisoner?
I don't think so.
And I have the right to know why. And I'm not going anywhere until you tell me.
Do you feel in charge?
Well, I don't think Amos is the one to really play with.
Dr. Strickland pulled your daughter out of the clinic an hour before the battle started. He's still on Ganymede, and we find him. I believe we'll find your daughter.
You can stop pretending to care about my daughter. What does she have to do with this proto-molecule you're after?
How do you know about that?
I told him.
Loose lips, sink ships.
He's helping us. You should be straight with him.
The proto-molecule, is that what really moved Eros? Could that have to do with May?
We don't know yet. But if it is there, a threat could be even worse than Eros.
We're gonna do everything we can to find your daughter. What was Strickland treating her for?
She has a genetic disorder. He gave her regular injections.
Of what?
He kept her alive.
That can't be a coincidence.
Yeah, what did he give her?
Proto crap and a genetic disease. What was his connection? We'll ask Strickland when we find him.
Infrastructure network smashed. How are we supposed to find anyone there?
Well, the first step is getting there. We'll leave this in an ambulance once we dock, and then we'll intermingle with the locals.
And then?
And then we'll assess the situation and take it from there.
Your plan's always this vague.
This is about average.
We're very lucky. We certainly had our fair share.
Hey.
We leave this in an ambulance to land. How are we supposed to get back?
Plan A is hitching a ride to an outgoing relief ship. Plan B.
Better be me. So if anything goes south down there, y'all just holler. Cappy will come running. I will quietly deorbit, no burn, hug the surface, and we will rendezvous at one of these surface airlocks here.
Which one?
Scoop you up, strap in for a max burn up and out.
With every torpedo that every MCRN ship in orbit can launch, heading straight at us.
Yep. That's your plan. I hope good luck rubs off.
They have been pretty lucky.
They have been.
I'm glad that they acknowledge that.